tied again yesterday in their second round. And today we'll see Brazil back in action. We'll see USA, Venezuela, Scotland as well in Group D. And then Canada and Argentina are facing off after this over on pitch one at 1 o'clock. The Netherlands started their tournament brilliantly, and they'll be looking to continue with in that vein today. A win will see the Dutch through to the second round. I'm Stephen Jamieson, I'll be your commentator for today, and I'm joined by Ben Adams for the first time at this tournament. And Ben, I know you're really excited to be here.
Yeah, it's been a great tournament so far. We've seen plenty of goals, and hopefully we're going to see a few more today, Steve.
Yeah, absolutely. And Netherlands were excellent against Argentina. And who are the men to watch, do you reckon, in this game so far?
Well, today I'm really excited to see Joey Mensa starting today. And it's also Guido Floor's first start for the Dutch cerebral palsy side. So we're interested to see how he's going to do today.
Yeah, his first World Championship game. So we're very much looking forward to it as we enter the national anthems. So a very warm welcome then to St George's Park today, number 4 of the Cerebral Palsy World Football Championships here at St George's Park. My name is Stephen Jamieson, I'm joined today by Ben Adams. A very good morning to you, Ben. I know you're very much looking forward to this one. This is the Group C match between the Netherlands and Northern Ireland. And a very warm welcome to all of you joining us on the live stream around the world today. But for the benefit of those here with us at St George's Park, utilising the audio description service, here is all the information that you need to know. Our commentary position is situated just about on the halfway line, opposite the main stand. To our left of us is a wooded area. To our direct right is the Dutch dugout, and further away to our right-hand side is the Hilton Hotel complex. This should just allow you to gain some perspective on the commentary. If you're not sure where you're seated, or if you require any other information or assistance, please contact your nearest steward or official. It is the Netherlands versus Northern Ireland today. Both teams just lining up in their respective formations as we speak. And we'll run you through the team news. In goal for the Netherlands, Stefan Boersma. Number 2 is Jeroen Set. 3, Jeroen Schuytert. 8, Lars Kanijn. 9, Rick Rodenburg. 12, Guido Floors. 15, Joey Mensa. And for the Northern Irish, it's Darren Lemon in goal, Christian Canning, Cormac Burt, Jordan Cush, David Levy, Ryan Walker, and the 16-year-old Jordan Walker as well. The Dutch are in white today, with the traditional orange being represented in their shorts. And they have white socks as well. And the Northern Irish are in all blue, as they were in their first game, as we await the kickoff. As we await the kickoff here at St George's Park over here on pitch 2. And Ben, you're joining me today for the first time this tournament. I know you're really looking forward to it. What are you expecting from this game in particular?
I'm expecting goals. Holland was so impressive in their 4-1 victory over Argentina in their last game. they'll be looking to carry on that form today against a confident Northern Ireland team.
Yeah, Northern Ireland with a loss in the first game against Canada, 3-1 defeat to them. So if they're to have any real chance of progressing, you'd imagine they have to beat one of Netherlands and Argentina, which is a very tough ask for the Northern Irish squad. But we've seen stranger things happen, as it's going to be the Netherlands who are going to kick us off, playing from right to left as we look at it here from our commentary position. And we're just awaiting the signal of the referee, who is Stuart Campbell, and he gets us underway here on day 4 of the Cerebral Palsy Football World Championships. And it's Holland immediately in possession over on the right-hand side with Set. And he cuts in field to the centre circle with a bit of pace, and gets across here to Joey Mensah, the left defender for the Dutch. Plays it down the line to Floors, who gives it back towards Mensah. It's a good bit of pressing from Ryan Walker. And eventually it falls here for Skoytert. Now with Joey Mensah. Back now with Jeroen Skoytert. And now Set. Cuts in field again towards the centre circle over on the far side. And he comes across to the near side now for Mensah. Checks back on halfway and goes right into the middle of the centre circle for Skoytert. Holland just feeling their way into this game with a bit of possession. Into the centre of the Northern Irish half is Lars Kanani. Plays to the right-hand side now for Set. Looks to beat his man. He does so down the wing. Cross comes into the middle, but that will go harmlessly out at the near post. Darren Lemon more than happy to see that one out for a goal kick. Is it? You know, Set, the number two on the far side, looking to make headway. Changed Dutch side from the one that started the game against Argentina so successfully. No Ilias Visca, the man of the match from that game. He's arrested for this one. It's the number nine, Rick Runrug, who leads the attack as Jeroen Sait goes and makes headway down the right-hand side. He's well stopped by Northern Ireland. Here comes Levy in the midfield. Northern Irish skipper. And he goes left towards Burt. It's down the line, but it's knocked out of play by Christian Kenning. And the Dutch now have a put-in on the far side, just inside their own half. And here's Jeroen Skoytert, plays it to his left-hand side for Joey Mensah, just inside his own half, just left of centre. Down the line, offering an option is Guido Floors. And here comes Skoytert again. And he switches across to the far side, and Jeroen Sait has seen plenty of the ball in this early opening passage. As, it's now Kanain over on the far side by the corner flag, back at the line to Sait. Now Skoytert onto his left foot, just right of centre, cuts back onto his right, down the line goes Kanain. Can he keep it in? He can. He needs to find room, and he does, to Set, and it's teed up for Skoytert just on the edge of the area. He takes a shot, left footed, it's well blocked. Northern Ireland can clear here, and a chance here to break for Walker down this right hand side. Crosses halfway, he's got Mensah for company. And Mensah in the end seals him out, a really good bit of defending from the Dutchman. 24-year-old Joey Mensah with a lovely bit of defending to deny Ryan Walker, who has plenty of pace, and he tried to utilise it there, but he's well shepherded away as the cross comes into the middle, and Holland can break it through the number nine, Rick Rodenburg. It's well tackled on the halfway line, but the Dutch back in possession now with Jeroen Skoytert inside his own half. Onto the halfway line on the right hand side is Jeroen Sait. And it's down the line towards Rick Rodenburg, who tried to ease away the defender Jordan Kush, but that's comfortably dealt with by the Northern Irishman. And Holland can get us back underway from the throw, which they do, just inside his own half now. It's Jeroen Skoytert, and his pass is a little loose. It's a Northern Irish throw, and it's been an interesting opening, Ben. Plenty of possession for the Dutch, but not much incision going forward.
It has been a really patient passing game from Holland so far. Haven't seen too much incision, like you say, Steve, but we'll see how they do later on in this game.
It's now Joey Mensah in possession then for the Dutch, just inside his own half, left to centre, goes down the line here to Floors. Takes on the number 10 of Northern Ireland, that's Jordan Walker, 16-year-old, and the youngest player at this competition. He gets the throw. Here's Guido Floors into the corner of the area for Rick Rodenburg, who turns beautifully on the edge of the area, looking to find room for a shot onto his right foot. There it is! It's just wide at the near post from Rick Rodenburg. Really good effort.
First chance of the game so far. He's a big guy, Rick Rodenburg. There's a touch of a Peter Crouch about him, but he's got a really good touch and a good right foot. Good effort.
And Darren Lemon was scrambling away to his right-hand side there. Closest we've come to a goal by some distance as Jordan Kush has it in the defence for Northern Ireland, but it's a risky manoeuvre. Eventually, Northern Ireland could get it away after a tackle by Canaan in the midfield, pushed them back to their own area. And here come Holland again in possession with Joey Mensah. Long ball down the line. He's picked out Lars Canaan beautifully on the left side of the area. What a pass that is. But it's a good bit of defending from Ryan Walker, tracking back all the way. Jordan Walker, I should say. Tracking back all the way to make the challenge. It's put in for Holland just inside their own half on this near side. It's now Jeroen Schoytert. Joey Mensah switches the play across towards Sat. Schoytert again just inside the centre circle on this left-hand side. And here comes Guido Floors. Ball down the line towards Rick Rodenberg. He's back towards the corner flag and he gets clattered there. But Guido Floors can carry on just inside the area. Pulls it across and there's a chance here for Sat, who tees up on the edge of the area for Canaan. It's well blocked. May fall for Sat again, but it's cleared away by Walker. There's an injury on this near side to the Northern Irish player Ryan Walker, who took a real clattering there. Rick Rodenberg as well. He is on his feet, but feeling the effects of that challenge. It's a heavy collision on this near side. As three players went tumbling. Play continued though from Guido Floors, and Holland almost found themselves an opening.
Yeah, they did. It was really good football down the left-hand side. They fought just on the edge of the box where the right-footed shot was going to come in. Unfortunately for Holland, it was blocked. But they are starting to be a lot more incisive in this first half.
And happily it looks like Jordan Walker, Ryan Walker should I say, is going to be okay to continue. He's been looked after by the physio. And he looks like he's going to be all right, which is good to see. And we'll get back underway then. Referee Stuart Campbell just making sure everything's in order. And he gets back underway with Northern Ireland possession just inside their own half. Play continues here with Rick Rodenberg, who's sent again tumbling to the floor. As Ryan Walker joins the fray again, but it's a free kick to Holland. About 20 yards from goal, just right of centre. Lars Canaan and Rick Rodenberg showing an interest in this. Canaan, the Dutch skipper. Two men in the Northern Irish wall just outside the area. Remember, no offsides in seven-a-side football, so Jeroen Schoytert is making his presence felt in the goal mouth there to distract the goalkeeper. It's a good set piece from Holland as they get the ball down the right-hand side of the area. Shot comes in from Rick Rodenberg, but it's well held by Darren Lemon. One straight off the training ground there as Rodenberg ran over it and Canaan fed him into the right side of the area. And a kick from Darren Lemon is sliced out of play for a Dutch throw. Guido Floors will take it, the number 12 of the Dutch. And Lars Canaan offers himself short and gives it back to Floors and then helps it back into his own half for Jeroen Schoytert. Good ball down the line to Floors. He's seen plenty of possession here on this near side. Switches the play across towards Jeroen Sat, but that will just escape the attentions of the right winger. And then it'll be a Northern Irish throw, almost bang on halfway. But Holland utilising the wings very well. Not quite getting the final ball required so far to find the opening goal.
It's a really well worked free kick we saw just a minute ago. They've seemed so well prepared for this tournament, Holland.
Yeah, the set pieces have been a feature of Holland's play. They did score from a free kick in the first game against Argentina through Elias Visca. There's that Northern Ireland with another throw in a more advanced position. About 5 minutes played here at St George's Park on day four of the Cerebral Palsy Football World Championships as Northern Ireland goes back underway on the far side. But Jeroen Sat is first of the ball, and Rick Rodenberg now can pick it up just inside his own half and run at Jordan Kirsch, but it's a good tackle from the Northern Ireland defender. And now Joey Mensah with the ball just inside his own half, switches it to his right hand side inside the centre circle for Jeroen Schoytert. Joey Mensah on halfway, drives inside the Northern Ireland half here under pressure from Walker. Schoytert now over to the right hand side and Sat. Rick Rodenberg just holding the ball up on the right side of the area, back to goal, looking to find room for a cross. He has one man in the middle, but the cross goes directly behind, and that will be a Northern Ireland goal kick.
Holds the ball up really well, Rick Rodenberg. Definitely a player to watch in this game.
He is, as you mentioned, Ben, a very tall figure, the big number nine, 22-year-old. Northern Ireland goalkeeper gets his back underway here down the far side, but that's not quite kept in by Cormac Burt. And the Dutch can get themselves a throw. Here's Joey Mensah then. Plays it across to the far side in your own set. Drives at the defence of Northern Ireland, gets past them on the right side of the area. Really good covering challenge by Jordan Cush. And Cormac Burton come away with it now for Northern Ireland, but he's dispossessed by Lars Kanine just inside the Northern Irish half, and it's all the way back to the goalkeeper of Holland. This is Stefan Boersma. First touch of the ball for him. There's the Dutch have dominated possession. Northern Ireland solid in defence, but not too much going forward so far from them. Joey Mensah, the ball flight up to Rodenburg. Looked to chest it down to Kanine on the edge of the area, but the touch evaded Rodenburg for once. That goes harmlessly through to Darren Lemon. In all yellow in the Northern Ireland goal. Walker with the ball to his fellow Walker down the line. That was Jordan towards Ryan. But the ball in the end comes out for a Dutch throw. Floors on the near side. Drops into Kanine and gets it back. Ball down the line is a good one. This is Sat now on the left-hand side towards the edge of the area. Good interception there by the captain Levy. Ball here for Kanine here on the edge of the box on this right-hand side. He switches it across. He got a touch from Cush on the way. That'll be a Dutch throw over on the far side midway inside the Northern Ireland half. Pressure building. Northern Ireland defending with plenty of men behind the ball. Rodenburg rolls it in to Kanine. Gets it back and then plays it to halfway for Jeroen Schreutert. This is Joey Mensah. Schreutert again. Is it long towards Sait down the right hand side? He cuts infield onto his left foot. Shot comes now on the right foot from the edge of the area. Well blocked. A fall here for Mensah. Halfway inside the Northern Ireland half on the left hand side. Now Guido Florzu tucks it around Walker but can't get on the other end of it. And Northern Ireland now back in possession in their own corner flag. They can't quite clear it there and it'll fall to Rick Rodenburg, corner of the box on this near side. Mensah flights into the area. Sait brings it under control and tees it up for Kanine. Left footed but over the bar from Lars Kanine. He has got a lovely left foot as we saw in the first game with that cultured finish against Argentina. The captain not on the score sheet this time around. Better though from Holland.
Much better. Really good assist there from Jeroen Sait. Held the ball up really well. And picked an intelligent pass to the right-hand side of the penalty box.
It will be Darren Lemon who gets his back in the way in this one for Northern Ireland. This is Jordan Walker who goes long down the line looking for Ryan. But it's well read by Stefan Boersma. And Schreutert can now have it for Holland on the right side of their defence. Now on the left side of it is Joey Mensah. Ball up to the front line towards Kanine, but it's well read by Northern Ireland. Kanine with a lovely bit of strength there to muscle Burt out of it. He takes a shot from range, it's well blocked. Might fall here for Rodenburg with a header inside the area, but it's not much contact on it from Rick Rodenburg, and Northern Ireland can get it away here through Walker, who's got two nutmegs there on Joey Mensah, I think. As the ball gets knocked down the line towards Jordan Walker again, who made the run, but Ryan, the number nine, Ryan Walker couldn't pick him out. And Holland back in possession now with Jeroen Schreutert, who finds Joey Mensah just inside Northern Irish half, left-hand side of it, and the ball forward is well intercepted by Walker. And here comes Guido Floors. Left-hand side, Joey Mensah. Guido Floors ahead of him down the line, comes infield to Lars Kanine, edge of the centre circle in Northern Ireland territory. Now Schreutert, who lost it forward towards the Northern Irish goal, but that goes out for a corner. It was deflected on the edge of the centre circle. And a chance for Holland to load the box here.
Could be dangerous for Northern Ireland. They're a tall team in the Netherlands, so certainly Rodenburg will be a target here.
Yeah, Guido Floors, Rodenburg and Schreutert all on the larger side. As the ball gets flighted in, there is Rodenburg rising, but he's well edged out of it by Burt, I think it was, in the mix there. Falls here for Kanine on the edge of the area, plays into Sait, and now Rick Rodenburg from the edge of the box, but the shot goes just wide of Lemon's right-hand post, closest Holland have come.
Carbon copy of the effort that he had a few minutes ago against Sait, getting into that left-hand side of the penalty box. He's drifting in, and he does get in there unmarked.
Really good opportunity for Rick Rodenburg, whose radar has just been a touch off so far in this one. The Category 8 player. Remember, each team is allowed one Category 8 player on the field at any one time, and they must have one Category 5 or 6 as well. All the athletes here at the World Championships categorised from 5, 6, 7 or 8. Most are 7s, but as we say, the regulations require at least one Category 5 or 6 athlete and only one Category 8 athlete. One of the many slight differences in the rules from the 11-a-side game here on the 7-a-side format. Others include, as you may have guessed if you're not familiar, the smaller pitch and smaller goals, no offsides, and roll-ins are allowed as well as throw-ins. But other than that, it's very similar to the 11-a-side game, as we've discovered in the opening 4 days of the championships. If you didn't know it already, it's just as entertaining. As Jordan Kush happily appears to be okay for Northern Ireland, and he's ready to come on from this near side after receiving a bit of treatment from the Northern Irish physio, and they're underway again. Northern Ireland from the goal kick, and here comes Cormac Burt just on the far side there inside his own half. Looks to flight one down the line. It's a good ball as well towards Levy. He can't quite keep it in. The Northern Irish skipper makes a throw in to the Dutch, and Lars Kanaan takes it back to his goalkeeper Bourgeman. And now Mensa on this near side, left side of the defence for the Dutch, and he switches the play over towards Kanaan. I think one might have even taken a gust of wind halfway across. It swerved away from Kanaan. And from Northern Irish throw just inside Dutch territory on the far side. It is not as breezy as it was yesterday, but there's certainly a wind in the air as the flags dotted around St George's Park are fluttering. That's another throw on the far side, but this one goes to the Dutch, and Jeroen Schoytertz gets back underway. Rolls it into Kanaan, who's got time, but he chooses to knock it back to Schoytertz and move himself up the field. Jeroen Mensa with Guido Fawkes available to his left-hand side, just inside Northern Irish territory. His touch is a little loose, and it just drops out of play. Under pressure from Jordan Walker, who rolls it in from the throw. This is David Levy. Ball inside towards Cormac Burt, but it's well read by Setz. David Levy eases side out of it though. It's a good 50-50 scramble in there in the middle of the park, and then it'll eventually fall for a Dutch throw on halfway. Dutch coach in the technical area, Marcel Giesman, commanding his charges to move further up the field. Here comes Joey Mensa. Plays it into the centre circle for Schoytert. And here comes Kanaan, left side of the middle of the Northern Irish half, points to the middle, and there's Rodenberg, oh, and off the post. And that now is the closest Holland have come, and they won't get much closer without scoring. It rolled all the way across the line and somehow evaded the goal. The foul throw over on the far side, but what a chance that was for Rick Rodenberg. Lovely work down the left-hand side, a cross in was perfect, and Rodenberg's finish was a matter of millimetres away from supplying the Dutch the lead.
They're getting closer and closer and closer, Steve. It seems like it's only a matter of time.
There's Northern Ireland take the throw, and they've won themselves another one further up the pitch in front of the main stand over there. There's that, it's rolled in by Canning, and eventually it's played up the line, but Schoytert is easily able to pick that one off as the ball goes over to this near side. Mensa will just about keep that in. I think he does very well. And he couldn't quite keep it in the end with a second touch. As Minesh Gupta signals for a Northern Irish throw. Jordan Walker gives it away though to Guido Fawkes on halfway as he knocks it down the line and looks to follow it, but touch just a little bit loose. And it's going to be Jordan Walker again with the put in for Northern Ireland just in this near side. There's options down the line, but Guido Fawkes cuts that one off, but Cormac Burke can eventually find Ryan Walker, who's crossing halfway now. Just right of centre, he plays it to the left-hand side where Levy will go to chase with Schoytert. Levy looks to race down the line to beat Schoytert, but he's very, very experienced. The Dutch defender seals him away. And eventually, Joey Mensa should get that clear under pressure from Burt. And he knocks it down the line to Set. And a chance now for the Dutch to counter-attack, which we've not had too much chance to do. The ball goes into the centre circle for Kanaan. Got Guido Fawkes overlapping on this. Guido Fawkes overlapping on this near side, and here he is. Ball goes into the middle towards Rodenberg, appeals for handball, waved away, falls for Kanaan, edge of the area, sweeps it in, and a really good save from Lemon in the Northern Irish goal to claw it away down to his left. Really good stop to deny Kanaan as the Dutch get ever closer. It's all the way back with their goalkeeper now, Bourgeman, into the centre circle for Mensa, switches across to the far side and Schoytert. We're moving up through the gears with Jeroen Seitz. He comes in field, crowded out though, but he will get to the second ball there, Set. You can't quite keep it in. And it's a Northern Irish put in. And Darren Lemon with an unbelievable save there.
It's a really good save. He might have even tipped it onto the post as well.
Just keeping out Lars Kanaan, which would have been the skipper's second goal of competition after his lovely opening strike in the first game. And the Netherlands participating in one of the best games of the tournament so far against Argentina. High quality affair ending in a 4-1 victory for the Orange. As it's Canning looking to escape down the left-hand side, but Holland Dertlening do just that, and that's going to be a throw-in on the far side, which is taken by Sat. Scheuter gives it back to him down the line. Sat now picks out Mensah in the centre circle. Got floors down the line, but he opts to turn the other way and goes instead to Sat on the right-hand side. Little ball down the line towards Rodenberg, who gets ahead of Kush to get there first. Rodenberg twisting and turning towards the corner flag, looking to find room. Eventually squeezes it out back up the line to Scheuter, who beats a man and then runs up the line. Scheuter, good tackle by Jordan Kush to dispossess him, sliding in there, the number five. Really good challenge. David Levy can run it away now for Northern Ireland down the Dutch right, but it's a good bit of defending again from Yoey Mensah. Very solid, isn't he, the Dutch defender?
Yeah, both the Dutch defenders today have really impressed. So physically imposing, they're stopping every single Northern Ireland attack.
It's been a solid defensive display in both respects, really, from both teams. The Dutch have had more chances, but Northern Ireland are just about keeping them at bay so far. As of coming up to the 17-minute mark here at St George's Park. It's Yoey Mensah on the ball just inside his own half left of centre. Pauses. Goes to his right hand side for Scheuter. And it's now with Aaron Sat on the right hand side. Drives in field towards the edge of the area. Switches the plane out to Floors. Into the edge for Canine, but the touch was a little bit loose from Canine. It was a difficult ball to control, in fairness. And here come Northern Ireland looking to release Jordan Walker down the right hand side, but he won't quite catch up with that. Yoey Mensah will beat him to it. Mensah launches one cross field towards Aaron Sat. Brings it down well on his right foot and looks to beat Canning for pace down the right-hand side, but cushes across. He's very quick to beat Sat to the ball. It's such an advantage in the Northern Irish defence, having someone like Jordan Cush, who is so quick across the ground. As Holland goes back underway, Scheuter across to Mensah, pings it into the feet of Canani, who takes it beautifully on his left foot. Shot comes in now, low and hard, but it was straight at Darren Lemon, who makes the save. You get the feeling that was the... That was one of those, if it was in the corners, there was no way Lemon was getting anywhere near it. Caught it really well, Lars Canine. In the end, Darren Lemon holds on. The 30-year-old goalkeeper, who kicks it into the centre of the field, and Canine heads it away in the centre circle for a Northern Irish throw, right on halfway. Taken by Jordan Walker, and he looks to find his namesake Ryan down the line. And Yoey Mensah just eases him out of it there. Northern Irish coach on this near side. Yeah, Alan Crooks appealing for a free kick, but I think that's just a case of Yoey Mensah just being too big and strong for Ryan Walker there. And here is Mensah again receiving it from the goal kick from Bourgeois. Now across to the right, Scheuter.
No, obviously, quite obviously you can't do it.
Down the line to Sat. Back into his own half is Scheuter. Into the feet of Canine, middle of the Northern Irish half. Unleashes another shot, it's a good save from Lemon. Might fall for Rick Rodenberg, right side of the area. Tees it for Sat on the edge. Can't quite get the shot away, and now it's Canine on the edge of the area. Takes a touch, and there's the shot, and blocked by Walker. And eventually, Northern Ireland scrambling away and win themselves a free kick with a handball of Canine. But the Dutch are really turning the screw here, and they're getting closer and closer.
Canine's doing a really good job at finding some space on the edge of the box. That left foot's looking really dangerous.
The shot just blocked him there. I think it was Jordan Walker who got the crucial block on Canine's strike. Maybe saving his team from going 1-0 down there.
Okay, here we go, team football.
It's going to be Darren Lemon to take this free kick then for Northern Ireland, just inside his area. And it goes into halfway, and Levy flicks it on. Walker is driving towards the area, but in the end he can't quite get on the end of it. Now it's Levy again, and now Jordan Walker up from the right side. Canine seals him out though, down by the corner flag, and the clearance is deflected, but Yoey Mensah now can help it away. Now you're onside. He's got Rick Rodenberg ahead of him to his right-hand side. Looks to pick him out now down the wing. Here he goes, Rick Rodenberg approaching the edge of the area, running at the defender, gets by him down the line, looks to pull it back towards Guido Floors, but it's well defended in the end by David Levy. Sorry, Christian Canning it was who got the block. And it will be a corner to the Dutch. And they do look especially dangerous when Northern Ireland do go forward and there's a little bit of space left behind them to counter-attack into.
Yeah, they do. Really good pace from the Dutch team. It was the first time, really, they've been able to commit players forward Northern Ireland, and they nearly paid the price for it.
Corner to be taken on the far side by Guido Flores. Sait offers a short option. Goes into the near post of Scheutert, who looked to get a flick on, but Darren Lemon in the end got the better of him just about as the defender Jordan Cush is surging up the field towards halfway to look to get on the end of that clearance, but in the end he's beaten to it by the Dutch defender. And on the back in possession now inside their own half is Guido Flores on the right-hand side now popping up. Down the line is Sait. Flicking in field, but it's good defending again from Canning. And it's going to be a Dutch put in on the far side, middle of the Northern Irish half. That's a foul. Throw, or roll, rather, from the Dutch on the far side, and that's going to be a Northern Irish throw in their stead. There's that, the referee gets to look as looks to get us back underway as we approach the end of this first half, only 8 minutes left of it. Is Rick Rodenberg, who looks to tee it up for Canine on the edge of the area. He slides in to try and beat Jordan Walker to it, but couldn't quite. Jordan Walker is well tackled by Yoey Mensah. Eventually it's hacked away by Cormac Bird all the way to the goalkeeper of Holland, Stefan Boersma. Here come the Netherlands then with Jeroen Scheutert. Down the right-hand side is Jeroen Schet. Driving at the defence of Northern Ireland, but again they stay strong. Scheutert wins it back and the Dutch back in possession with Lars Kanine. Down the left-hand side now is Guido Flores. It's the midfield. Here's Mensah, middle of the half. And a good strike from range from Jeroen Schet. But that's high and just over the bar.
Put off by the challenge there of Cormac Burt. They've defended so committedly, Northern Ireland. They really have put 110% effort into this game.
And they certainly have. No doubt about that, as it's played to the right hand side for Jordan Walker. It's given away now to Lars Kanine. Down the line is Guido Flores. Two men to aim at in the middle. Looks to beat Jordan Walker down the line, but it's a good tackle from the youngster. And it's going to be a corner to the Dutch. Jeroen Schet comes across to take it. It's red and black boots. Rick Rodenberg, Jeroen Scheutert, and Guido Flores to aim at in the middle. Lars Kanine and Jomens are hanging out outside the area. It's short to Flores and then given back to the corner taker and pinged all the way across, and then it'll go all the way through for a goal kick. It's a really good ball in from Sait, but no one on the end of it.
Only needed a touch.
But it is that touch, that final ball, that final finish, which has just about evaded the Dutch so far in this half. Goal kick goes long for Lemon, but that will go all the way through to his opposite number, Boersma, and he can roll it out to Jeroen Scheutert, right defender of the Netherlands. This is Mensah. Cross back to Scheutert on halfway. Forward up to Rick Rodenberg, edge of the D, and he teases it for Lars Kanine, who strikes it low and hard, but it's well blocked. In there by Jordan Cush, I think, and it'll fall here for Ryan Walker. Right side of the half, but he can't quite get round Yoey Mensah, who's mentioned before, a big, strong defender. He's difficult to get past, and Ryan Walker hasn't got too much joy so far. This is Jeroen Scheutert, middle of his own half, coming towards halfway now. Goes it to his left-hand side for Yoey Mensah. Knocks it down the line, but it's well intercepted by Jordan Walker. He looks to feed it away to Ryan Walker down this right. Got Mensah for company. Ryan Walker has pace, though. Towards the corner flag he goes. Held up by Mensah. He'll do well not to foul him. Walker looks to try and get a corner out of the defender, but it's well defended in the end by Horn, and they look to get it away, but Jordan Walker's battling to get it back. In the end, it's stabbed away by Mensah, only as far as Levy, but Rick Rodenberg dropping off the front to dispossess the Northern Ireland midfielder. And look at the pace of Rodenberg down the right-hand side. Even Jordan Cushy struggling to keep up with him, but he just about does. And a really good sliding tackle from the Northern Irish defender. He berates his midfield for losing the ball in the first place, but Rick Rodenberg really getting a chance to open his legs there and stretch the Northern Irish defence. Pausing players. Jordan Walker just has some tying of his laces to attend to. It'll be Guido Flores to take the corner on the far side. It's Sait, Rodenberg and Scheutert, who are in the middle. It's taken short to Sait, who looks to stab it back to Guido Flores, but it's a loose one. And Northern Ireland come away with it here on the far side with Levy. Drops into the middle for Cormac Burt, and that will be a Dutch throw. Cormac Burt can't quite believe the decision. Lars Kanine with the ball in his hands then. rolls it in. Too short to back down the line towards Kanai, but he's interrupted by Levy on that far side. Kanai with the throw down the line towards Rodenberg. Kush at his back, and in the end, he can't quite control it, Rodenberg. And it's going to be a Northern Irish throw on the far side, despite Rodenberg's protestations that he was pushed. And in the end, the Northern Ireland defence hack it away. As Yuri Mensah brings it under control just about inside his own half. Looks a long, booming ball towards Rick Rodenberg, who is challenged by the keeper. And Sait looks to knock it back into the area where Lemon has vacated, but in the end, it's Northern Ireland who clear it away. A booming tackle there from Yuri Mensah puts Ryan Walker on the deck again. As we head towards the end of the first half, 2 minutes of added time signalled by the referee's fourth official. Jordan Walker tackled again by Mensah, who hasn't let one thing get by him in this half. He's superbly Dutch defender. This is David Levy. Stabbed into the north, Cormac Burt. That's switched across towards Christian Canning, who's got Rodenberg challenging him. And Rodenberg wins it back, slightly loses his footing, but stabs it across this near side where Guido Flores will challenge with Walker. But Walker gets there first, only as far as Mensah though on halfway. Tries to play into the middle, but that's a rare loose pass from Mensah. And here comes Ryan Walker, right of centre for Northern Ireland. Attacking the edge of the area, looks to put it through the legs of Mensah. Can't quite do that, but he maintains possession. Over to the left-hand side, and Canning, and into the middle here for Cormac Burt, attacking the edge of the area. And Sat just got back to make the challenge. And it almost opened up there for Northern Ireland at the end of this first half.
So close, he just looks a little bit uncomfortable on his left foot. Best chance of the game there for Northern Ireland.
Just a rare venture forward to the edge of the area for the Northern Irish team. Roll in, taken by the corner flag on this near side by Walker. Gets it back from Levy, looks to go down the line. He squeezes across and does really well. There's Walker teed up on the edge of the box now for Jordan Walker, who takes the shot right footed, but it's blocked by Sat, and he has pace. He'll look to get away down this near side to run Sat, but Kush comes across to make the challenge.
He has got in the way of everything in this first half, Jordan Kush.
Ryan Walker just suffering a little bit there with a knock. Yeah, he's taken a couple of heavy challenges in this first half, Ryan Walker. Looks like he's going to be okay. And it's Sat who will take this throw on the near side into Guido Flores. No Sat again. Halfway line is Mensah. Poor ball from Mensah, that's the second one in a row now. And here's a chance for Northern Ireland to attack with David Levy, but that's a recovery and a half from Yoey Mensah, who slides in to make the challenge and put it out for a throw on this near side. It will be Ryan Walker to take. Got David Levy as an option. Here's Jordan Walker on halfway there. Back up the line, he plays it down the line again to Ryan Walker. Into the middle towards Levy, but it's given away. And in the end, that is half time. And it'll be Northern Ireland who enter the interval, the happier you'd imagine. The Dutch frustrated a couple of times by some dogged Northern Irish defending. And a couple of hits to the post as well. But at half-time, it is 0-0 here in the first game of day four at the Cerebral Palsy Football World Championships. We'll be back with you in about 15 minutes' time. If you're on the live stream, don't go changing. And if you're at the venue, feel free to get yourself a refreshment. It is pretty nippy here around St George's Park, so get a cup of tea and return back to us in 15 minutes' time for the start of the second half. Welcome back then to the coverage here of day number four at St George's Park of the Cerebral Palsy Football World Championships. The Dutch team just making their way back onto the field. Chatting actually to a couple of the Dutch substitutes at halftime. And they're very confident that they're going to get the win in the end. But they have struggled in the first half to break down this Northern Irish defence, who've defended very well, but in a couple of really close openings, a couple of hits at the post and a couple of really good saves from the goalkeeper, Darren Lemon, in the Northern Irish goal. But you get the sense that one will then lead very much to two and three.
I really do. They're finding space on the edge of the D. Conine on his left foot is looking really dangerous. Darren Lemon's had to make several good saves from him. And of course, the big guy up front, Rick Rodenburg, he's a huge threat.
He certainly has been the Dutch's best attacking outlet, Rick Rodenburg. Hit of the post from him midway through the first half was very, very close. Hit the inside of the post and rolled all the way across the line to then go out for a goal kick at the far side of it. You don't come much closer than that. Northern Ireland, though, had one threatening break towards the end of the first half. They haven't offered too much in the way of a forward threat, mainly due to the very solid Dutch defence. But we await the second half with great anticipation here. This Group D clash, between the Netherlands and Northern Ireland. We've got Canada versus Argentina coming up for you shortly at 1 o'clock. And our attention is still very much focused on this one, because there's plenty to play for. 0-0 at the interval. And just to wait all the players to make it back onto the field. And there's going to be a substitute, actually, for Northern Ireland. As Ryan Walker comes off. He did seem to pick up a couple of knocks in the first half, Ryan Walker. But it's Stephen Halpin who makes his way onto the field, the 21-year-old, number 7 for Northern Ireland. It's going to be he who trots across to take the kickoff with David Levy, the Northern Irish skipper. And we are back underway in the second half then, and the ball comes out to this near side. And it's out for a Dutch throw for Jeroen Schuytert. And he rolls it in to his defensive partner, Joey Mensah, who strolls up to the centre circle and drives one forward to the edge of the area towards Rick Rodenburg. Here's Rodenburg again, he battles away, and it comes here for Knijn, who manages to reverse it across here, just inside the Dutch half on this near side for Schuytert. Down the line to Set, running at the defender, stood up well. Back up the line to Schuytert. He's forced to go all the way back to Bojma in the Dutch goal. Schuytert, who lined up a long raking ball towards Floors, but that's well cut out by Northern Ireland. A lofted ball over the top from Cormac Burt. It's a good one. That's Joey Mensah under a little bit of pressure from the substitute Halpin. In the end, the Dutch defender is as solid as ever. And the Netherlands keep the ball through Bojma, the goalkeeper, now with Jeroen Schuytert on the right side of the Dutch defence. Into the Northern Irish half, and Set looks to turn past Canning. He can't quite get the better of the Northern Irish defender. Set looks to keep it in, which he does. Linesman says play on. It's back now with Schuytert, who switches the play across to the left. And Mensah back across to the right now towards that Set, but that will go on out for a throw in this time, definitely to the Dutch. At 10 yards or so from the corner flag on this near side. Number 2, Set will take it. Got Knijn straight ahead of him. Here he is, Lars Knijn, the Dutch skipper. Into the corner of the box on this near side. Back heel from Floors, looks to pick out Rodenburg, but it's well intercepted by the Northern Irish defence, and they get it away. It's another Dutch throw over on the far side after Mensah was stopped by Halpin. It's Mensah with the throw then, midway inside the Northern Irish half. He rolls into Rodenburg, gives it back to Mensah, down the line to Sat, who's over on the far side now. Jinx away from one, but Jordan Kush just sealing him out. Sat battling away though, and eventually Jordan Kush gets better of him, but illegally, says the referee. A free kick to the Dutch in a decent position here. Rodenburg looks to take it quickly, it's blocked by Halpin. The referee's just going to allow the Dutch to take that one again. Men arriving into the middle of the net. Rodenburg stood over this free kick. He's got Knijn on the edge of the D. Schuytert and Sat at the back post. Floors at the near post. Only Mensah back anywhere near the halfway line. Every Northern Irish player is back defending. Two men in the wall. sat in front of the goalkeeper. It's squared across. It comes all the way across this far side, this near side rather, towards that. Troy Turley's battling away there with David Levy. Again, the Northern Irish coach not too happy about the physical battle that Schreuter was enjoying there with Levy, saying the Northern Irish skipper was fouled, but the referee says nothing doing, and indeed it is a Northern Irish ball with the throw in as it's rolled down the line and Levy can't get past set. There'll be another one just in front of the Northern Irish coach, Alan Crooks. Canning rolls it in, it's knocked down the line by Levy towards Bert, who looks to get around the outside of Schreuter, but he's a very hard man to do just that to. And Holland get it away down the far side towards Flores, but it's cleared by Jordan Walker. Just inside the Northern Irish half are the Dutch, and they roll it back onto play. And into the centre circle now is Jeroen Schreutert. Down the right-hand side it goes. It's repelled by Northern Ireland. Schreutert beats Cormac Burt to it and then beats him into the edge of the box towards Rodenberg, but the ball doesn't stick. And Northern Ireland can get it away. It's very much been a theme so far in this game of the Dutch struggling to break through this wall of blue shirts.
Yeah, Northern Ireland really defended deep at the start of this second half.
Struggling to break through as the ball gets floated in towards Rodenberg. And there he is, but he just misses the header. Really good opportunity there for Rick Rodenberg. Just couldn't quite connect with the header. And Darren Lemon would have had a hard job, keeping that one out if he had. Best opening of the second half so far. We'll play 4 minutes. And Lemon takes the goal kick short to his left-hand side for Canning, who fizzes it into the midfield. Canine is there first for the Dutch. And here's Canine again on this near side. Knocks it back towards halfway and Schreuter. Got a man over on the far side. It's Guido Flores, which is really well read by Jordan Walker to repel that attack. Stefan Porsche is all the way out of his goal. He knocks it to Mensa. Left side of his own half. Floats it up towards the area. Jordan Cush's header is behind him rather than in front of him. And Rick Rodenberg almost profited, but in the end it rolls to Jeroen Schreuter, who gets it to Set in the centre of the field. Edge of the box, shot comes in, deflected, hit Rodenberg on the edge of the box. And eventually Northern Ireland can get it away down this left-hand side with Levy. Beats Rodenberg, but can't get around the other side of him. Canine's there to intercept, and here comes the Netherlands again. And Rodenberg couldn't quite bring the pass under control. Not happy with the quality of delivery there, the big number nine. And there'll be a Northern Ireland throw right by their own corner flag. Petter Kurij and Minna de Vos currently warming up for the Dutch. Substitution maybe in the offing for them as the Northern Irish defence eventually get it away, do they? Yes, they do, with Darren Lemon. Mitchell, as far as Mensah, who fists it down the left-hand side for Guido Flores. He beat his man Jordan Walker. He can't. Good defending again from the youngster. 16-year-old Jordan Walker having a great game down that right-hand side for Northern Ireland. It's going to be another corner.
A few sloppy passes creeping into the Northern Ireland team's game.
There, the corner's taken short to Joey Mensah. He's forced to go all the way back to his goalkeeper, Stefan Borsma. He drops it back into Mensah just inside his own half, left-hand side of it. Schreuter wants it and gets it on this near side. He's got sat down the line, but he comes infield again and gives it to Mensah. Down the line it goes to Guido Flores. He looks to roll in on past Jordan Walker. Good play from Guido Flores, and he cuts infield here. Now Rick Rodenberg. Chance might fall here for Set on the edge of the box. Back to goal. Just slightly right of centre. Can he find room for the shot? He can. It's deflected just wide off Jordan Kirsch. It'll be a corner. Right behind that one. We were in our commentary position. And it looked like it might have just been creeping in the corner without the deflection.
Could have been. Dangerous effort. He's a really, really good player, Jeroen Set. Really comfortable on the ball. He's so dangerous when he drifts in from right to left. He's so tricky.
And here we go then with the corner. It is Set. He floats it in towards the near post. And there's Rodenberg. He couldn't quite get the connection required on the header. And Lemon makes the save. Goes straight down the field out of his hands with a long punt. But that'll only go as far as Joey Mensah. And the Dutch can recycle possession here. Bit of a wasted giveaway there from Darren Lemon. A good chance in the middle there for Rick Rodenberg. Here's it. The Dutch down the left-hand side, cross comes into the far side, and it's a good header away under pressure from Christian Canning. It's a Dutch throw, is it, on this near side? It's a corner taken by Lars Canine. Into the feet of Stett, gets it back here, Canine. Floats it into the near post. Schreiter rising and he couldn't quite get the touch. It was Lemu who claimed it behind him and he had to. Zetchar prepping two subs as Schreiter has it just inside the half and there's Rodenberg inside the area. Onto his right foot he goes. Brilliant block by Kush. Didn't quite fall for set. And the Dutch are applying all the pressure here. In the end, it's going to be a Northern Ireland throw on this near side. It's Mina De Vos and Petr Kurij. Ready to take the field. Just waiting for confirmation of that double change. In the end, it's Northern Ireland who take the throw. It is a foul throw. And Dutch now have a chance to get their substitutes on the or are they going to take the throw in first? They do. Rick Rodenberg down the line to set. Rodenberg back now by the corner flag. Back up the line now to Schreiter. He's beaten to it by Cormac Burton. Now the Northern Ireland team can counter-attack. He's got Levy to his left-hand side. And the pass is over hit. And Cormac Burton is so frustrated with himself. Giving the ball away. But the play continues. And the two substitutes still waiting to come on. Here's Kanine in the centre circle. That's this near side and Mensu tries to feed Rodenberg on the edge of the box. He's well hassled again by the Northern Irish defence. Long ball out to this right-hand side and Sat, who brings it down, but he's touched a little loose and it'll fall here for Cormac Burt, who can get it away. And now David Levy down this near side. Needs a little bit of support. Cormac Burt is the option. And it's a good Dutch tackle in there. The substitution will now be made. And on such decisions, our game's changed. It is Guido Floors who is to be departing first for the Dutch. And Petr Kurij comes on to replace him. And Rick Rodenberg is also replaced by Mina De Vos.
Two good performances in the first half from Rodenberg and Floors. But a change of tact might just be what the Dutch team need. They're pushing Northern Ireland back further and further into their own box.
Guido Floors completes his first ever World Championships appearance for the Dutch. A big moment for him and a good performance as well as the Dutch are back underway. Mina De Vos has taken Floors' place over on that left-hand side when Petr Kurij has gone up front for the Dutch, number six. Here he is, and he looks to link up with his substitute, Mina De Vos, floated down the line towards the winger. And he's battling away on the far side of the area, can't quite get the touch, and eventually it's given as a goal kick to Northern Ireland. Early indication of Mina De Vos' ability, though, down that left-hand side. Very elegant player on the ball. And the goal kick taken short down the right for Jordan Walker, who feeds Halpin just inside his own half, but he's dispossessed by De Vos. He comes in field now to Kurij. Looks to play De Vos in down the left-hand side of the area, pulled back, and there's the goal! And the substitutes have paid dividends. It's your own set for the Netherlands. The two decisions made by the coach to substitute Kurij and De Vos has very much paid off, as they were very much involved in the build-up. And the square ball was a good one. And your own set will not miss from there.
Really good late run into the box by Jerome Sett. He's done that time and again today. And as you see, De Vos showing how dangerous he can be coming on from the bench.
A very, very cool finish from Jerome Sett, the number two. He's popped up in some really good positions for the Dutch so far in this game. And it is he who scores the opening goal. 1-0 here, 41 minutes played in this one. Really, really important goal for the Dutch. A win here would see them qualify for the next stage. And that is the aim for this team. And at the minute, they're achieving it. Here's Jeroen Schreuter just inside his own half. In the centre circle, plays to the left. And Joey Mensah, who down the line, finds Mina De Vos, who steps away from Jordan Walker. Brilliant fleet of foot from Mina De Vos. Helps it down the line towards Kurij, who scoops it up over the challenge of Jordan Kush and wins his team a corner. But you see that extra added bit of quality from Mina De Vos on the one-on-ones there.
Yeah, he's a really exciting player.
Corner taken down the line to Mensah, flights in across. It's towards Kurij, but he's beaten to the ball by the defender, who heads it out for another corner. That's a Kurij. We'll take this corner. Just waiting for the official to say it's in the quadrant. The wide footballs always try and steal that extra inch. Here's Kurij, though, who will take it. towards the edge of the area. It'll fall all the way through here. Will it? No, it's a little bit short from the Dutch, and the Northern Ireland team can counter here. Walker looks to launch it forward towards Halpin. It's a really testing ball for Set. Halpin can't quite get on the end of it, and it's really good defending from Johan Set. He runs it away down this right-hand side. Levy comes across to tackle him through the legs from Set, but it's Canning who retrieves it on the other side. Kind of Kuic with a challenge just in front of us, and another one from Kuic. And he knocks it inside the edge of the own area of the Holland defence, and here's Yoyi Mensa. Switches across this near side, and Jeroen Schuurtert down the line towards Set. Under pressure, but he manages to keep possession. This is Schuurtert. You've got Canine on the far side of the area. The pass on, which turns into a shot there from an incredible distance from Schuurtert. Comfortably held there by Darren Lemon in the Northern Ireland goal. And here's the team in blue who get us back underway. Down the line towards Halpin, but it's well read. And the Dutch can get us back in the rhythm of their possession. And this will fall here for Courage, and back to him from Set, and he goes for the 1-2 again. Couldn't quite latch onto it, could your own Set. And oh, it's a mistake from the goalkeeper, Lemon, and Set can feed here to Mini De Vos. Real chance here to make it 2. It's Mini De Vos who makes it 2. The second goal of the competition for Mini De Vos after scoring in the opener against Argentina. And it's a horrible moment for the goalkeeper, Darren Lemon, who was too impatient and his role was inaccurate. And it was an easy finish in the end for Mini De Vos.
Easy finish, but he took it so calmly. Really good place finish there on his left foot. And Holland completely in control of this tie now.
We've played 44 minutes. We have about 15 minutes of this game remaining. And the Dutch have finally got the 2 goals that their players long threatened in this game. Northern Ireland's defence has finally given out. And it will come as a source of great frustration, no doubt, to that defence, that having defended so well. It's a sloppy goal that they've conceded for the first. For the second, rather. The first was a good goal, which defences can sometimes write off, but individual errors are very frustrating for a team to concede, having defended so well for the rest of the game. And it is the Dutch back in possession then on halfway with Yoyi Mensa, driving into the Northern Irish half. In towards Courage on the edge of the area, who takes a touch and comes back out. Looks to turn. And goes back to halfway. For Schuurtert, now to Mensa. Gets it back in the centre circle, Schuurtert. Rolls it out to this right-hand side for Set, who plays into the edge of the D for Courage. Couldn't quite bring him under control, but he keeps possession. And so to Holland here with Yoyi Mensa in the centre circle. Flights out to Courage on this near side. Good touch from Courage, but he can't quite squeeze it through the legs of Canning. It's a good tackle from Canning, but Holland really pressing him well. And Courage sets it up for Mini De Vos here on the edge of the D. Can't quite squeeze it through to Lars Canine. Can he get the shot away? No, he can't. Really good tackle in there from Cormac Burt. Courage keeps it in play by the corner flag. Back at the line now to Schuurtert. Courage just happy to wait in possession as he plays back to the edge of the centre circle in Northern Ireland territory for Mensa. Into the feet of Canine on the edge of the box, who tumbles. Appeals for a free kick waved away. Schuurtert making his presence felt in there. Good tackle from Mensa. And eventually, Jordan Kirsch will hack it away as far as David Levy. The Dutch pressure is relentless here, and Mini De Vos is the deepest player of all as the defenders are getting involved as well. Mensa and Schuurtert. Here is Schuurtert, who's back in his normal position here on the right side of that defence on halfway. He plays it down the line to Sat and into the middle now for Konine. Into the edge of the box for Courage. He drops off to the right-hand side for Sat, who will keep that in. Back at the line to Schuurtert. Patient in possession again, the Dutch. Into the centre circle is Yoyi Mensa, who strikes it left-footed. A good strike, but Darren Lemon will face tougher shots than that in this game. Pretty comfortable save in the end for Darren Lemon. Didn't quite hold it, but he got there at the second attempt in front of Petr Kuric. And Lemon gets his back underway. At his feet, Stephen Halpin now, just in the edge of the centre circle, but he can't quite hold on to possession. Yoyi Mensa has been immense whenever a player has been running at him. Don't think he's lost one tackle. And here is Yoyi Mensa, finds Set in the middle of the Northern Irish half, but he's lost out. And now helping Mensa again in with a tackle. And the Dutch are back in possession with Schuurtert. Goes down the line to Lars Konine. Lovely back heel into the area, but it's well dealt with by Canning. Halpin now can bring it away for Northern Ireland. Ball to his left is a little loose, and Lars Konine can pick it off. Into the edge of the D for Courage. Now that's the right hand side for Sat. Back to Courage, about 20 yards out. He takes a shot left footed. That was a little loose though from Courage, and there'll be a goal kick to Northern Ireland.
Disappointing effort, but it really has been Courage and DeVos that have made all the difference in this second half.
An injection of something new.
Holland look a completely different team, and they weren't bad in the first half.
They certainly weren't, as Northern Ireland clear it away. It will predictably be Yoey Mensah there first. And here is Set on this right-hand side, level the edge of the 18-yard area. Pulls it across to the far side of Minnie DeVos, who tees that for Yoey Mensah, who strikes it over the bar. Couldn't quite keep the shot down. But again, good football again from the Dutch.
Not afraid to hit it from range. Got a few players out there with a sweet left foot.
Not quite sweet enough on that occasion for Yoey Mensah. Darren Lemon smashing it long up the field, but there's no Northern Ireland attacker on the end of it. It's almost a 3-3 formation currently for Northern Ireland. No recognised forward. Here's that Courage down by the corner flag on the far side. Lovely feet from Pinar Courage. Back at the line to Yoey Mensah, who feeds it towards the corner flag of Minnie DeVos, who wins his team a corner. And there's going to be another Northern Irish change. It's Shea Teague who's been ready. But, the change is going to be made, in fact, now. And we are going to see Stephen Halpin replaced. The player who was brought on at half-time to replace Ryan Walker is now replaced himself. And Shea Teague. Teague, rather, will enter the field of play.
Looks like he's taken a little knock here, helping.
Yeah, an unfortunate end to Halpin's game as he limps off. A touch frustrated. Shea Teague enters the fray. His first job will be to help defend this corner. Yaron Set stood over it, flights it into the near post, but Darren Lemon will comfortably deal with that. He's got men up ahead of him here, Darren Lemon, as the kick goes long out of his hands. But no one is there to challenge Yoey Mensah, who've launched it long back into the area, but straight into the hands again of Darren Lemon even. There's Northern Ireland back in possession in their own half, flicked on towards Jordan Walker, heading back into the middle of the half, but Lars Kanaan will get there first. Header away by Jordan Cush. That's Teague who will keep it alive for Northern Ireland in their own half. But constant Dutch pressure high up the pitch has meant that Northern Ireland have struggled to get out here. And it's again the Dutch in possession with Schuiter out to his near side and Courage. That's a lovely reverse ball to, you know, and Sat, who couldn't quite get the shot away. David Levy with a challenge. Goes up the line with the clearance, but it's only as far as Petter Courage. Good switch of play from Courage to Mensah, who goes for the 1-2 in the area, but the pass is a little bit loose. Eventually it's cleared as far as Schuiter from Northern Ireland. Courage into the feet of Minnie DeVos. Edge of the area, shot comes in and well blocked. That'll be another Dutch corner, and they're racking up. Courage, who comes across on this near side to take it. 28-year-old, left footer. He was one of the Dutch players we were chatting to at half-time, and he was confident of a win. And well, he might be if he's going to come on and perform like he has. As Northern Ireland clear the corner, clear their lines. But the ball from Jordan Walker can't quite pick out David Levy. And it's Holland back in possession now. The goalkeeper Stefan Poortsma, and he finds Yoey Mensah, floats it down the line towards Lars Konijn, but he's got a big job on his hands there. The Dutch skipper's again on the end of that, and it's going to be a Northern Ireland goal kick. We've got about 8 minutes left of normal time here before stoppage time at the end of the first game of day four of the Cerebral Palsy Football World Championships here at St George's Park. A win for Holland will take them through, and at the minute they're doing exactly that, 2-0 the scoreline. Goal kick taken and headed on, but that's Jeroen Schuiter to knock that back towards Lemon, and indeed he controls it, the Northern Ireland goalkeeper. He brings it out of play and knocks it down the line towards Jordan Walker, but the pass is a little bit loose from Lemon, who's trying to lead his troops from the back. As Mensah will do the same for Holland. What a ball that is across to Courage. He brings it down beautifully on his left foot, but can't quite maintain possession. Jeroen Set, his first and second ball, though, ahead of Cormac Burt, and that'll be Stefan Boersma in possession for Holland. He drops it into Sure, it's a 2-0 to Holland, but as we said, Stefan Borgman hasn't actually had to make a save. There's that. Holland come forward again with Joey Mensah down the left-hand side. Looks to play 1-2 with Kanijn. It's now Kurij who drops deep and finds a look set on the right side of the area. Kurij again. Plays into the edge for Mina Devos. It's been stabbed away by Northern Ireland. Little four here in the centre circle for Set. Just no one up there for Northern Ireland. No out ball for them. This is Schoitert. This is Mensah. Schoitert again into the feet of Kurij. Just inside the Northern Irish half, drifting left. Good feet from Kurij, who gets away from the challenge of Jordan Walker. Tries to poke it down the line to Mina Devos, but it's a good challenge here from the substitute, Shea Teague. He's running forward. He's got support to his left-hand side and David Levy. Here's Cormac Burt, and the pass is a little bit loose from Cormac Burt. He feels his left calf after releasing that pass. And he's gone down as well. That might be an injury. Well, Cormac Burt, he might just have pulled his calf or maybe felt a touch of cramp at the end of this one as he played that pass. Physio comes on for Northern Ireland. We can just take stock of what's gone before us in this game. It's been a very entertaining watch, as ever, here at St George's Park. And then it's been Holland who eventually look like they're going to come out on top.
Yeah, we mentioned in the first half that they weren't too incisive, Holland. Lots of possession on the edge of the box, but no through balls making their way. But in the second half, it's been a different story. Range of passing has been excellent. DeVos has been fantastic, playing in the forward position on the left-hand side. Kurij has made a real difference as well, coming on from the bench. But Northern Ireland, as you mentioned earlier, they're struggling without having a centre forward on play. No out ball. So every time they try to break forward, Holland are getting the possession of the ball back fairly easily.
So it's been a Dutch boomerang, the constant attack. When Northern Ireland clear it, it just comes straight back at them. It looks like Cormac Bird is going to be okay. 19-year-old. Netherlands back in possession here in their own half with Joey Mensah. He plays it up to the edge of the area towards their own set. Nearly falls there for Kurij, but it's cleared. And here is Cormac Bird, who does appear to be feeling no after effects of the injury. And he looks to play it free for Jordan Walker, who's battling away with Joey Mensah. But predictably, it is Joey Mensah who comes out on top and finds his goalkeeper. And releases it down the left-hand side for Mina Devos, who has pace. Gets there ahead of the Northern Irish defender. And Mina Devos cutting in field now and playing it across the field to Kurij. And Peter Kurij is annoyed he hasn't scored that.
Wonderful chance. Again, DeVos beats his man and plays a beautiful slide rule pull across diagonal, across the edge of the box. Kurij really should have scored.
Curled wide of the far post from Kurij. You can see exactly what he's trying to do. Open up his body, back across the goalkeeper. It wasn't on target. Darren Lemon's under a lot of pressure here from your own set. And the pressure from set has forced Lemon out for it to concede a corner.
Typical of Set's game, he hasn't stopped running all match.
Is that we're going to see the final change. It's Christian Kenning who's coming off after another hard-working performance. And it's Charlie Fogarty who's going to make his first appearance at these championships. Good performance from Christian Kenning, who's worked very hard in that Northern Irish defence. Yeah, Darren Lemon has made a couple of questionable decisions in that Northern Irish goal. Been solid when asked to do the goalkeeping side of things. But a touch shaky in his distribution and decision making, it has to be said.
He looks a little bit nervous when he gets the ball to his feet.
There's that. The Dutch await to take this corner on the second take after the first one was stopped by the referee. It's Set who whips it in towards Schoiter with a header, and it's just over the bar. A little bit wide as well there from Schoiter, I think, but a good effort nevertheless.
Yeah,
not far away.
Alan Crooks will be disappointed that their defence led him in unmarked without a header.
Corner to be taken then. Sorry, goal kick rather to be taken then by Darren Lemon. And it goes long up the inside right of Northern Ireland's attack. It's beautifully controlled by David Levy, who looks to break past Joey Mensah. As we've learnt throughout this game, Joey Mensah is not a man who is easily broken past. And a throw-in it is to the Dutch team. After Mensah seals out David Levy. Here is Schoitert, right of centre, middle of his own half. Brings it forward and passes down the line to Kurij. Back to halfway line for Jeroen Schoitert. Little reverse ball back to Kurij, who's brought down there. Schoitert play continues. Back to the centre circle for Mensah. Ball down the line is a good one for Sert. Again, it's full of running. Ball back up the line now to Mensa, and the pressure from Walker. He floats it back towards Jordan Sert, and what a ball that is. Sert round the goalkeeper, chance. Oh, a clearance off the line for Jordan Cush. My goodness me, that's up there for save of the tournament. And he's a central defender. Wonderful block there from Jordan Cush as the Dutch continue to press with Kuij back inside for Lars Kanaan. He can't quite get on the end of it. And eventually Northern Ireland clear. Down the line, it's a good ball too for Jordan Walker, who's got him behind Schoeter. Mensa comes across. Walker being stood up here by Mensa. Step overs, and Sol Rozenhoy looks to get by him. And Mensa just seals him out, and Schoeter is able to complete the job. And he's fouled by Jordan Walker as he attempts to clear. But just going back to that clearance from Jordan Cush. Sert did everything right, went round the goalkeeper. Shot was low and hard on target. And he did not anticipate Cush being there to defend it. Absolutely superb from Cush. As the judges get us back underway quickly from the free kick, it's switched across this near side and Kuij inside the Northern Irish half, chest it down and looks to find a reverse ball into Lars Kanaan on the edge of the D, but it's well defended by David Levy. And Cormac Burke can now get it away down this near side to Levy. Plays it infield to Jordan Walker. His pass rather hits Cormac Burke rather than being controlled. Knocked down the line by Fogarty, but that is given out for a Dutch throw. It's rolled in by Schoeter. He exchanges passes with Mensa. And here is Yoyi Mensa again. Edge of his own centre circle. Flips out to this near side, but the pass is a little bit loose from Mensa, and he chastises himself in the centre circle there. Schoeter couldn't quite get on the end of that. So throw in then to Northern Ireland. 30 seconds left of regular time then in this one. We'll wait to see how much stoppage time is added, but it looks like the Dutch are sailing on through Group D here. A win will seal qualification, and Sert is looking to add the icing on the cake here, but he's well tackled on the edge of the area by Cush, predictably. And there Fogarty will get this away down this near side. But there, it's a good bit of play by Peter Kuij, who dispossessed him. Kuij cuts inside onto his left foot. Here he goes, Kuij looks to stab it forward, appeals for handball, nothing doing. And it's out to halfway. We'll have 3 minutes of added time here at the end of the game. Sert down the left side of the area for Minna DeVos. Across the field it goes, and all the way across the face of goal. Kuij couldn't quite get on the end of it, and Darren Lemons got all the way out of his goal. We get this clear. Places up the line. Slightly loose passenger, and Schoeter is on the end of it. Infield now to Sert. And it's Lars Kanaan, edge of the deep. Feeds it into Kuij on the edge of the box. Looks to turn. Sweep it home with his left foot, and that's beautiful down by Petter Kuij. Who makes it in the Netherlands 3, Northern Ireland 0. And that is the icing on the cake of a very good Dutch performance.
Deserved goal there from Kuij. He's had a few attempts. That was his best one by far. Really cool, calm finish into that bottom corner.
Beautifully swept home by Petter Kuij on the turn from the edge of the area. And the Dutch are 3 to the good. And it's a scoreline that their second half dominance has perhaps deserved. As Northern Ireland gets back underway on the far side with Jordan Walker. It's a good run here from David Levy. He'll get there ahead of Schoeter. Touch just deserts him though, and Schoeter can get away on the far side for a Northern Irish throw by the corner flag.
A brave performance from Northern Ireland. They've put plenty of effort into their game. Just beaten by the better side today, Steve.
Yeah, the Netherlands looking to target the semi-final stage, at the very least, the world number fours. There's Jordan Walker trying to find a way out against Yoyi Mensa, who's happy to let him sit there. Northern Ireland do find a way out, and here's David Levy, corner of the box on the far side, looks to squeeze in a shot, but that's well blocked, and Kuij can bring it away here on this near side. Good pace from Petter Kuij. Drives in field past the centre circle. Got Minna DeVos in your own set ahead of him. He might not need him, it's still Petter Kuij. He's eventually tackled by the last man, which is Fogarty. Storming break there from Netherlands number 6. He comes to receive the ball from the throw-in from Schoeter. Kuij looks to play it in towards Minna DeVos. Well defended by Cush. And here's Kuij again, plays into the edge of the D for Sert, who drops it out left to Lars Kanaan, the captain. Floats into the far post. And Schoeter is waiting, but he won't quite get on the end of it. And that's a goal kick to Northern Ireland as we head into the final 30 seconds of this game. Lemon with the goal kick. short to his left-hand side for Fogarty. It's Jeroen Sutton who's nipped in ahead, and that's Minna DeVos to make it four. And Fogarty lost possession. Sutton made him pay. And Minna DeVos gets his goal.
Goal and two assists in this second half for Jeroen Sutton. He has been absolutely fantastic today. He has not stopped running. And again, another example of him winning the ball off the Northern Ireland defence and playing an intelligent pass across the left-hand side of the penalty box. Easy finish for DeVos.
Well, how much of a difference had the substitute made? A goal each now for Minna DeVos and Petr Kuiš. Assist as well for Minna DeVos. They have been superb. They've made the difference. And Jeroen Sutton has also done just that as well for Holland. Northern Ireland gets back underway. The final throws of this game. The referee checks his watch. Cormac Burt shoots. And that will just about do us on pitch two here at St George's Park. The first game of day four of the Cerebral Palsy Football World Championships. And a very good one it was as well. 0-0 at half time, but in the end, the Netherlands made their quality pay. Goals from Minna DeVos, Petr Kuiš, Jeroen Sutton. And a fantastic performance in the end from the Dutch, who will go home very happy after this one. They head into their third game, knowing that they are qualified for the second stage. And Northern Ireland are needing snookers in Group D. If you have been utilising the audio description service here in the venue at St George's Park, please return your receiver to the place or person from whom you received it. And if you are heading on over to pitch one for the next game, which is Canada versus Argentina, you'll need a different receiver for that one. And to those in the live stream, we will see you in about 35 minutes time for the next game over on pitch one, which will be Canada versus Argentina, which could well decide who ends up in second place in this group behind the Dutch. But a very good performance from them, and just enough time, Ben, to have one final look back at this game. Who is your man of the match?
I think it has to be. I mean, DeVos came off the bench and was absolutely fantastic, but for a whole 1 hour's performance, Jeroen Sutton was absolutely incredible. So he gets my man of the match today, Steve.
A fantastic performance from Jeroen Sutton, and he is the man of the match for this one. As the sun comes out at St George's Park, we hope that it sticks around for the rest of the day. Three more games to come this afternoon, starting with Canada-Argentina in half an hour's time.